Welcome back, you're with Goa 365. The state witnessed a near total ban on Monday, the 20th of October. The ban succeeded in bringing the state to a grinding halt and virtually paralyzing all economic activities for nearly 24 hours. In addition to public and private property vandalized at a few places, numerous trees were also cut at certain areas to be used as roadblocks. We at Goa 365 try to catch the pulse of the common man and understand what they felt about such political bans.
I don't think bans should be promoted. Whatever opinions you have, whatever you feel or your way of protesting should be done, is democratically done, but not by means of disturbing the whole social setup, you know, blocking the roads and, you know, burning the tires and all those things. They are completely coming in the way between the people's free movement, like, you know, you express your whatever you want to oppose, but not in the this ban is totally out of the way.
It hurts the public people. We inconvenience them, and it's a devil's work. If we have elected the government, why people public should go take the law in their own hand?
It's not a right idea of solving problems, because it is the innocents suffer with all their differences and whatever. The main thing, they should have found out the cause of the problems and then sorted out in a peaceful way, rather than creating all this confusion and chaos in the whole place.
Yeah, it is not right to do it like this. You must settle with some people, must come forward and think what should be done exactly, and then they should take decision. Otherwise it is problem for everybody, no? All people, those are working for them, everybody is getting disturbed after.
And I feel it is not at all right to do any type of protest through buns, because it hampers a lot of business. And you cannot go out. Often you require to go out in the hospitals and all that. But I mean, it's simply creating a chaos out of it. There's no point in doing such things.
To protest and to give the problem to all the public, it is not a fair one. It cannot be justified.
I don't think it's a correct for a ban, but I think the government should do, before the ban, some action the government has to take regarding the issue. Otherwise it's a real disaster for our people, because ultimately the people are suffering, not the government. And the main thing is because of the government.
It is not correct. Through ban, nothing will be solved. What has happened was wrong. So many people have suffered, students have suffered, then exams were postponed. I don't feel that with ban everything can be solved.
I don't know actually what purpose they want to serve by buns. We all know India is a developing country, and by buns, from poor becoming poorer. Think about the fruit and vegetable vendors who survive on the daily basis, whose income depends on the sale, day-to-day sales. The rich, influential and well-to-do might have a lot of things in their fridge. This might last them for 8 days and they might not mind. So who are the sufferers? And what is the message? Somehow, I condemn the act, but I feel a big meeting and expressing the views might serve the purpose.
Before protest karche pahile ami amche je higher authority asa tyanche kade discuss karpa jay. These are the problems occurring in the Goa, and these problems are to be solved by discussion. It is not that we have to get up and start protesting for any work.
Ani kidare truck jolelo, ani kidare fodle shopa fodle, finally loss konache government. What is government? People like us, we are government. So we are losing our money from our own pocket. If we are government, we damage the government. Government is our own. And second thing, Goa is so peaceful. Goa is famous for peace. And we are going to burn one, 98% success bond. Yes, totally, I don't like all this.
Well, according to me, I don't think this is a right way of protesting against something. There are many other ways, like if it is something that is done by the government, we should go and talk to the concerned people. Opting for a burn in Goa or even in small area, it is ultimately affecting the common man.
It has never helped anybody and it will never help anybody. They could have protested in many other forms, like having a dharna in some area, so that it does not affect the public life in general. I do not think so, because it disrupts public life to a large extent. I had seen the state of the bus stands, etc. on that day. Even people who had emergencies to attend could not do that just because the transport was closed. It's not correct to do that, because you never know how many people are there in a state of emergency. So it's better to do it in a place where it doesn't affect the community at large.
See, I feel that is not a right way to do it. What I feel it, see, every MLA is there, when appointed by the public, we have to give them a memorandum first in advance, okay, to submit the concern this thing. Because what I have noticed, most of the schools and colleges, they was having an exam. We students have suffered a lot. Not only that, people who are working daily basis, they have not got their daily income and all. This is not the way the burn has to take place.
By keeping Goa closed for one day, this doesn't mean that the problem is going to solve. Tomorrow so many temples they may attack. Do you think that every time they attack the temple, every time the Goa will be closed? This is not the solution according to me. My suggestion to the government is that government should contact NGOs, should contact the right person who are the temple authorities, and have a meeting with them along with the officers of the various departments and sort out the problem.
First of all, our government should have rectified the fault. Why exactly this is okay? And they should have tried to catch that particular culprit. So after, the entire way, the people there suffer a lot on that particular day. Because transport, there was no transport, there was all the hotels, everything was closed. So that means a common person.
The buns should never be called or given a call. Maybe their sentiments are in the right place. I may sympathize with the sentiments, but there are other means by which you can express your dissatisfaction or with the non-functioning or whatever cause that you are espousing. But calling a burn, you are responsible for whatever losses that are taking place. Our state, our nation today cannot afford to have any burns or any closures for their matter.
As far as industry is concerned, statewide burns affect industry's productivity as well as it directly, indirectly affects the economy of the state.
Burn is a national loss, is a state loss. And even it is a loss for the community. And I request and pledge upon to all the communities in Goa that they should not follow the burn, they should not support the burn. And henceforth, I feel that there should not be any burn anymore in the state.
Though such burns appear to be successful, the loss and damage they create is often irreparable, and this is rightly reflected in opposition to such burns by an overwhelming number of citizens. Though political burns have been banned and termed illegal by the Supreme Court of India, only self-realization by the common man only will help us get rid of this self-destructive way of protest. We'll be back with more news on the other side of this break. Stay with us.